Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I'm going to show you how to install the latest version of Eclipse IDE on Windows operating system. And after that, I'm also going to show you how you can easily use our Eclipse IDE for Java developers. So I'm going to write one sample code on Java and I'm going to run that within Eclipse IDE. So all those things I'm going to show you on this video. So do watch the video till the end. If you face any issues, you can always comment me on your comment sections. And I'm also on Instagram now, so you can also follow me over there. And if you are having any questions or doubts, you can always ask me by sending screenshots and everything over there. I'm definitely going to help you. So now to install Eclipse IDE, you need to first simply go to favorite browser and then you need to search over here, Eclipse IDE download, and hit enter. So that's going to show you this Eclipse download link. So you need to click on that link and it's going to redirect to the official site of eclipse.org/download page. So this link, this Eclipse Foundation page link, I'm going to provide right in our description. So once you are here, you'll see that our Eclipse IDE is available to download, right? So to click on this download x86_64 and it's going to automatically redirect to the screen. So again, you'll see a download button over here. So you need to click on that and immediately you will see that our file is rightly started downloading. So thank you for your download. You can see that our file is rightly started downloading. I have already downloaded it, so I'll cancel this. I'll minimize my browser. I'll go to my download directory and here you can see that the same exe file is already been downloaded over here. And the file size is just 132 MB. Right. So to install, you just simply double click on the installer and it's going to show you this Eclipse installer page over here. So let's first minimize our download directory. So our Eclipse installation wizard is rightly opened over here. Here you will see all these different options, starting from Eclipse IDE for Java developers to C or C++ or PHP, and all these different language you can use this Eclipse IDE for development. So in my previous videos, I have showed you how you can easily use Eclipse IDE for C or C++. You can also follow that video as well if you want to code in C or C++. But this video is going to be, you know, totally for Java developers only. So for Eclipse IDE for Java developers, you need to click on the first one. And here you will see that our Java path, it is given the latest GRE version, that is 2022. So right now on this system, I don't have any Java installed. So I'm going to download Java and install it along with Eclipse IDE. So that's why, you know, here if you click on this drop down, you'll get these two GRE versions that it is, you know, asking you to download. All right. So you need to select the latest one, that is 2022. And then, you know, all other things you can keep it default and you need to click on install. So it's going to ask you accept this license agreement. You can always read this and then click on accept now. And then it's going to start installing our Eclipse IDE. So as I told you, it's going to also install our Java, you know, latest version of Java. So that's going to take, you know, significant amount of time and to have also active internet connection as well. So it's going to fetch a lot of files from internet and then it's going to install it locally on your system. So it's going to take some time. So by the time it gets installed, I'll ask you, please do subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel. So here also regularly I'm posting lot of coding related videos. So please do consider subscribing our Geeky Syntax channel along with Geeky Script vlogging channel as well. Alright, so that will really going to motivate me to make more and more this kind of videos. So let's wait for some time over here. So we'll come back, and now you can clearly see that our Eclipse IDE is rightly installed. So we have this launch button over here. So you can always click on this launch button to start launching our latest version of Eclipse IDE, that is Eclipse IDE version 2024-09. And you can see that it is rightly launched. So first it will ask you to select one workspace. So I'm going to keep this default. So on our user's directory, it's going to create one workspace folder called Eclipse Workspace, and then within that folder it's going to, you know, create all the projects that we are going to create within Eclipse IDE. So, you know, let's keep this default and click on launch. So our Eclipse IDE is rightly started launching. and it has rightly launched. So welcome to Eclipse IDE for Java developers. Alright, so let's first maximize this. And this is the interface of our Eclipse IDE for Java developers. It's going to also redirect to this Eclipse Foundation page. So you can always donate some amount to them. That's going to really help them to develop this kind of products. Let's click on cancel over here and let's create one sample Java project. Let's first close this welcome note as well. So that will give you this interface. From here, you can also create a new project. So if you click on this create a Java project, that's going to open this create a Java project window, or else you can also go to file and then, you know, click on new, and then you can also click on Java project over here. So that's going to open this same window. Here you need to give your project name. So let's give the project name something like hello everyone, and all other things you need to keep it default. So our latest Java AC 22 is what it's going to use as our JRE, and all other things I'll ask you to keep it default. Again, uncheck this module part because it is just a simple, you know, hello world Java project. So let's keep, you know, a module out of it and click on finish. So you can see that our hello everyone Java project is actually created. If we expand this, you will see a src folder over here. So you need to select that src folder and then you need to right click to that folder and you will hover over new and then you need to click on class. So that will show you this Java class window. Here you need to provide your class name. So let's give the class name as hello everyone, and it's going to be a public static void main method. So you need to select this and then you need to click on finish. So that's going to create one hello everyone.java file over here, and that file also going to be open with our main method that is also been created. So here if you just, you know, type something like system.out.println, and within parentheses if you just write something like hello world, and if you just simply end with semicolon, so if you write this much, and then if you click on this run button, you will get the save and launch option over here. So you need to click on OK, and it's going to save this file and it's going to start building your project, and then you will see the output that is coming on our console, hello world. Alright, so in this way you can easily install latest version of Eclipse IDE on a Windows operating system. And after that, I have also showed you how you can easily create one sample project and how to run that on our Eclipse IDE itself. So that is basically all about this video. Please do subscribe our Geeky Syntax channel. That will really motivate me to make more this kind of videos. And also, if you're interested, you can also subscribe our Geeky Script blogging channel. So I'm traveling, I'm making some videos, so you can also follow that as well. So that is basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.